Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about the temperature scale as well as we will discuss about the temperature unit conversion. So here you can simply see the Fahrenheit, Rankine, Kelvin and Celsius scale we use to measure the temperature. So we will discuss that, what is the relation between them, okay, and we will also try to recall the definition of the temperature, right? And we will also understand that what is the concept of the temperature unit conversion. Okay, so let's start the video. Okay, so as I told you, there are four scales which is used to measure the temperature. Okay, so these four scales are your Fahrenheit, Celsius, Rankine and Kelvin. So here is one thing which I would like to tell you, that whenever we say Fahrenheit, so we will say degree Fahrenheit, right? Whenever we will say Celsius, so we will say degree Celsius, right? And whenever we have to say Rankine, we will say degree Rankine. But the Kelvin is, whenever we say Kelvin, so we will simply say Kelvin, okay? You can simply see in this conversion, in the relation between the Kelvin to degree Celsius. So Kelvin will be known as the Kelvin, but Celsius is known as the degree Celsius, okay? Could you let me in the comments box what is the reason behind it? Now, the Fahrenheit and Celsius, okay, are the relative scales, okay, Fahrenheit and Celsius, and your Rankine and Kelvin, these both are based on the absolute scale, right? Means Fahrenheit and Celsius are based on relative scale and Rankine and Kelvin are based on the absolute scale. Now, what is the meaning of relative scale and what is the meaning of absolute scale? So please let's understand about it. So mainly you will see like the TV anchor and the radio announcer is use the relative scales like your degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. The reason behind it, because it based on the specified reference temperature. What is the meaning of specified reference temperature? So mainly it refers to your freezing point of water. Okay, it is based on, or it is related to the freezing point of water. If you will little bit go behind the concept of degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit, then you will understand about it, because when it invented, so the concept of freezing point of water was involved there, right? Okay, and that's why we also study about the ice water mixture. Whenever we say 0 degree Celsius, whenever we say 0 degree Celsius, right? Okay, what is the absolute temperature scale? So when you say absolute temperature scale, simply you can also say the absolute or ideal, right? And it has their 0 point at the lowest possible temperature that we believe can exist, that we believe, okay? But it is a ideal temperature. When we say 0 Kelvin, okay, this is the ideal temperature. Now there is a one question for you all, and the question is, what do you understand by temperature? Okay, see, if there is one room, okay, in there is one room where there is one book and one iron bar, okay, and the room temperature is, the temperature of the room is, for example, 35 degree Celsius. Fine. Now, if I will ask you what is the temperature of this book, so what you will say? You will say 35 degree Celsius. And what is the temperature of the iron bar? What you will say? 35 degree Celsius or something else. But if you will touch this book, you will feel some hot. But if you will touch this one, so you will feel some cold, right? So mainly, like many times you will see when we read the definition of the temperature at the macroscopic level, so we simply find the definition is hotness and coldness of the body, okay? But at the microscopic level, when we understand the definition of the temperature, that is not the hotness and coldness of the body, it is more specific, and we say it is the average kinetic energy of the molecules, okay? That's why we, like when we touch the iron bar, so we feel some coldness, and when we touch this book, we feel some hotness, okay, because of their thermal conductivity. Please understand this point, that this point is very, very important. And if you will understand the concept of the temperature at the microscopic level, then only you can understand the difference here, the hotness and coldness, right? And the room temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, okay? So what is the temperature? Basically, temperature is the average kinetic energy of the molecules. Okay, now simply see here the concept of Fahrenheit, Rankine, Kelvin and Celsius. Okay, so when we say 0 degree Celsius, it means that the 0 degree Celsius is equivalent to 273 Kelvin. Right? Let me change the color. Okay, and it is equivalent to 492 Rankine and 32 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, when I am saying 0 degree Celsius. Okay, now when I say 0 Kelvin, so it is equivalent to minus 273 degree Celsius and 0 degree Rankine and minus 460 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, fine. Okay, now at what temperature degree Fahrenheit will be equal to degree Celsius? So it is the temperature minus 40. At minus 40, the degree Fahrenheit and degree Celsius will be equal. Okay, this is the just one question which is mainly asked in an interview and in a paper as well. Fine. Now see why I told you these. Okay, and at 100 degree Celsius, when the water boils in a relative scale, so that is 100 degree Celsius, which is equivalent to 373 Kelvin, 672 degree Rankine and 212 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so now one thing, if you will see the degree Fahrenheit, so from 32 to 212, okay, there is 182 points, you can say. Okay, from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius, there is 100. Same you can see here, 273 to 373, there is also 100. Okay, and say same here you can calculate. Okay, now on the basis of that table or that picture, what we could do, we can like make one formula, or we can provide the relationship between the degree Fahrenheit to Rankine, or Rankine to Kelvin, or Kelvin to degree Celsius, right? That you can see here. If you want to convert degree Fahrenheit to degree Rankine, or degree Celsius to Kelvin, degree Celsius to Fahrenheit, and degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius, you can do simply from here. Okay, like for example, as I told you, if my temperature is minus 40 degrees Celsius, okay, so what will be in the degree Fahrenheit? So simply we know that we have just read in our previous slide that minus 40 degrees Celsius will be equal to minus 40 degree Fahrenheit. So what we will do, we will simply put this minus 40 degrees Celsius in this equation. So what you will find here, you will find that the degree Fahrenheit minus 32 is equal to your minus 40 into 1.8, right? So now what it will be? It will be your 32 is equal to minus 72, right? So degree Fahrenheit will be minus 72 plus 32. So what will be the answer? The answer will be 40 minus degree Fahrenheit. I hope you understood this. Okay, and see, when you will put this minus 40 degree Celsius here, so this Celsius to Celsius will be cancel out, right? So that's why it will become here the degree Fahrenheit. So that's how you can calculate from these relation. Okay, the relation number 1, 2, 3 and 4. I hope you understood the point. Okay, and I hope you understood the the relationship between the all the temperature scales which we use, and what is the meaning of the temperature. If you have any comments, if you have any doubts, please let me in the comments box. I will definitely give the reply as soon as possible. So that's all for the today's video. Thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning. Thank you.